I've been doing this type of work for a little bit over 15 years now, and this is definitely something different. I've never done something this deep. Definitely enjoy the challenge. You just gotta be more careful. Up there on the 45, we can't be up there unless you're tied off. So we have people that are rope trained and they put their harness on, tie onto the ropes, and it's like rock climbing. You get paid to play, kind of.
Foundation grouting for large dams is a process by which geologic fractures, voids, are filled or sealed with a cementitious slurry called grout. Grout's composed of various components, mainly water and cement. You have to inject the grout under pressure into holes that are drilled in order to tighten up your foundation with the main purpose of decreasing the amount of seepage that goes underneath your dam. The grout curtain extends for a distance along the axis for almost 4,000 feet, and it extends to depths ranging from 80 to a little over 200 feet. A lot of the grouting is done on flat surfaces, but the inclinations vary. They range from 10 degrees up to 45 degrees on the upper portion of the right abutment. We started on the steep slope work on the right abutment within the last several weeks, and it's scheduled to go probably for the next maybe up to 3 months. And when you're on the 45 degree slope, you have to be very careful, very deliberate. It's more challenging. Safety is always a priority, obviously.
There's more steps involved with this. There's tuggers involved to pull the drill up. There's a platform that we call the mule. That's where we keep all the rods. So we gotta pull that up as well. So it involves more people and more communication to get to the hole we need to set up. Everything needs to be synchronized pretty much, come up even. I think we're coming along fine. There's been some areas where bad ground takes a lot more grout. That slows down a lot, but there's areas where it goes pretty quick.
Grouting programs for large dams are usually the hardest part to estimate because of ground conditions. What works in one area may not work in another. The geology can change. You do investigations and you learn pre-construction, but ultimately you don't really know what you have until construction starts. But you have to be systematic. We're trying to grout the foundation to a standard, and in order to do that, you have to be systematic and consistent.